We're going on a trip in our favorite rocket ship, this one. Check out my cool shirt. Instead we trust, yes we do. Actually, I'm putting on some extra clothes today because it's kind of cold. Sweater, gonna do full gear, boots, jacket, gloves, all of the gat. Let me show you my outfit of the day. And no, I've not had too much caffeine today, okay? I'm just excited. All right, yeah, here's the beautiful baby, the outfit of the day. Gonna put this on so we don't freeze. So while I do this, this is a collab with Doodle on a Motorcycle. We've collabed before. You can check out those videos if you want. They're on our channels. But today we're both gonna be sharing our experiences with commuting because both Doodle and I use our motorcycles to commute, her to work and me to school. And there's some stuff that you need to know if you're gonna commute on your motorcycle because it might take you just a little bit of prep work. Oh yeah, nothing like the feeling of a sweater bunching up in your armpits under your gear. Let's get some shoes. Oh my god, shoes. I haven't worn these shoes in such a long time. There's literally a spider web on them. But anyways, I'm gonna put my gloves on, put my helmet on, and then I will catch you guys on the bike.
Okay, welcome to the bike view. Let's talk about why commuting is awesome and why you should consider it. And if you do consider it, here are some things you need to know. I'll start off with a brief history of how I commuted. So basically, I would go 100 miles each day. It was 50 miles one way, 50 miles the other way on my way to school. And I would ride spring, summer into like the late fall, and into the late fall temperatures started to drop and stuff like that. So hello, bike dude. So I would be pretty cold. So I made some mistakes while commuting. I will let you know what those are. So hopefully you don't make the same if you do decide to commute. I still do commute to school, but I don't have to commute 50 miles one way now, which took me about an hour. Now it's a lot less than that, but I still do like commuting because I enjoy the ride into school. It frees up my mind. I used to moto vlog quite a bit when I was commuting. Those vlogs are up on my channel if you want to check them out. They're earlier. And I used to commute on a Ninja 250. The bike that you choose is going to make a difference on how nice your commute is going to be. I would say the Ninja 250 is, especially if you're starting out too and you want like a sport bike look, or the Ninja 300 now, or the Ninja 400. But those are probably all okay bikes to commute on. I mean, ideally, if you're just going to use your motorcycle for commuting, I wouldn't take a sport bike. But the Ninja 250 is okay because it doesn't have an aggressive seating position and it's not uncomfortable to ride even for a longer period of time. However, other more aggressive sport bikes like 600cc's and up, you might want to reconsider that. The second thing you want to consider when buying your bike is the type of roads that you're going to be traveling on. So is it going to be mostly backcountry roads like these, or is it going to be mostly highway? What does your commute look like? Maybe if you have mostly highway on your way to work, then getting a sport bike as a commuter bike is not so bad because it's just going to be highway, especially if your commute is not that long. So in that case, you'd be okay. But personally, I think if you're going to use a bike solely for commuting to work, I would say your best bet is to try and do something sport touring. A cruiser or a cafe racer. I mean, I can't really talk. I'm on an MT07. It's a naked sport bike. It doesn't really have a windscreen or too much wind protection. But I do like to take backcountry roads like this, so I don't find that to be a huge problem. So yeah, consider the type of bike that you're going to buy in relationship to how much you want to commute on it. If it's full-time, then maybe tailor that bike to your commute. Also consider the types of roads that you're going to be riding on, highway, backcountry roads, etc. And take into account the length of time that it's going to take you to complete your commute. Okay, another tip that I did wrong, this pertains to cold temperatures. Don't make the mistake that I did. You need to consider how long you want to commute on your bike for. Maybe you want to commute like throughout the winter, I don't know. I personally don't want to do that, but if you do, you're going to have to consider some special gear to keep you warm because it's really dangerous when your fingertips start freezing and getting cold and you get numb and it's harder to move them. You don't want to be in a situation where your reaction time is diminished because you're cold. So buy appropriate gear. I would pretty much just wear my leather jacket and these exact same gloves that I have on right now. They're not heated gloves, they're not anything special, they're just leather gloves. And it does get cold in them, not gonna lie. They do sell heated grips for motorcycles, so you could consider buying a pair of those. You could also consider getting a pair of heated gloves, they make those. In terms of a jacket, I think if you're going to be doing all season riding, your best bet is going to be getting something that is all season. So something like a Gore-Tex jacket, something that will be waterproof and windproof. That will help you out a lot in the winter when it gets cold. And they also make pants that you can put over your regular if you don't want to wear full gear on your commute and you just want to have like jeans or your work pants. On the bottom, you can buy an overpant. and it is basically like a windproof and waterproof pant that goes over whatever your regular pants are. Yeah, that way you don't have to deal with feeling the cold or the rain if it's crappy weather that day. Although maybe if you have really crappy weather that day, you should just skip the commute. Okay, so we've talked about a couple of things you could do to be ready for your commute to work. But I want to talk about why you should commute to work and why I do it. I don't think you'll find a single rider that would disagree with this. Commuting to work on a motorcycle feels good. If you enjoy riding motorcycles, it makes you happy. You're starting your day off with something that you love to do, instead of starting your day off worrying about, I don't know, spreadsheets that you have to fill out at work, annoying bosses that you have to deal with, annoying people and coworkers that you have to deal with. Sounds weird, but you're starting your day with self-care by putting what you love to do first. I know that sounds cheesy, but it really will help to put you in a better mood. And on top of that, let's say you have a crappy day at work. Well, you know who's waiting outside for you in the parking lot? That's right, Spicy Boy will be waiting outside for you and waiting to make you happy on your way back from work. The reason that commuting on a motorcycle feels better than commuting in a car is because on a motorcycle, you have to take in more sensory cues and inputs than you do in a car. Eventually, all these things do become second nature, but they're still there and they don't allow you a lot of opportunity to zone out, because if you zone out on a bike, it could be really bad for you. The other thing I want to mention is if you don't wear a helmet, I'm not sure that you can relate to this, but if you wear a helmet, like a full face helmet like I do, there's just something about looking at the world through your visor, like through your helmet. I don't know exactly how to describe it. I imagine it's like a much lighter version of what an astronaut must feel like when they're up there in space and they're looking down at the Earth and they just feel how small they are. It's just kind of like looking at the world through a different lens. That's the best way that I could put it. And I don't know how else to tell you to experience this other than get a motorcycle and ride, or ride as a passenger with somebody and see how it makes you feel. So yeah, commuting to work on a motorcycle definitely will put you in a better mood. It'll start your day off on a good foot, and you'll get to end your work day on a good foot because you also get to commute home on your motorcycle. Woohoo! So yeah, those are my thoughts on commuting. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Don't forget to check out Doodle's vlog as well. I'll leave all the links that you need in the description, and I'll put her video link here at the end as well. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!